This one is a little tough, mainly because I feel like people see it as just a, like, you're either this way or this way. We need to understand that, for example, in Nashville, they're building a stadium the same size, and it's costing them $250 million. The city was able to negotiate with the developers a living wage, a daycare on site, affordable housing, and many other things. We haven't negotiated any of that, and our stadium, while it has 10,000 less seats than Nashville's, is costing $2 billion, while there's this $250 million. And I think it's important to ask that what exactly would the money that you know, Kane is asking for, where would it go? And would that help with the luxury apartments that are going around it? And you know, if you're making apartments, et cetera, and they're not accessible to the people who are already living there, then ultimately you're pushing people out. Just because you're building a stadium on vacant land and you're not actually buying a apartment complex, et cetera, that doesn't mean the people around there won't get pushed out once the property value goes up and the property taxes or rental goes up. Many people in that area are rental, like they rent their place, not own it. So it's very easy for landlords, et cetera, to increase rent, and families aren't able to be there the following year. So I think we really need to ask ourselves the question, is this stadium going to do what's best for Southeast Raleigh? And if we're honest with ourselves, the answer to that question is no. It's not going to benefit the community. Research around the country shows that stadiums have not brought the economic impact that cities thought they would. I think we need to look at other cities, realize their failures and successes, and figure out what works best for Raleigh. But all the data and research points to this is not a good idea for Raleigh, and we need to figure out how we can work with Kane and others and build something that does benefit the community as a whole.